Hello everybody, I'm finally here with another video, which marks my second pink mock, and as you can see, it's the alternate model of the LEGO Overwatch 75973 D.Va and Reinhardt, and I call her She-Devil. First we're gonna take a look at this small side build, which is Reinhardt's jet or spacecraft, which is basically a tiny flying vehicle that resembles Eagle. Has the claws as the landing gear. The part of the hammer was reused as the jet nozzle. You can, without any problem, take him in and out of the cockpit. There's a little bit of pink since it was the last 2x2 plate that I had left. And here you can see the eyes and the beak opens and closes. That is the only function of this funny side build. So here you can see the main part of the alternate model, which is the She-Devil or She-D.Vil. So it's spelled similarly to D.Va, and as you can see probably over here, she's something close to 29 centimeters tall in height. I used most of the parts from the set, and originally I started with a regular male robot, but afterwards it started to look more and more feminine, so I decided that I need to twist it a little bit. So it looks like the female version of the devil on high heels. One word of advice for anyone who is trying to build and pose a big mech on something like this. Please don't do it, because it's pain in the butt to find the right balance, even though it's all right, but the poseability is limited because of the contact surface with the ground is not as big as if you had just a flat foot. The mech figure actually features one accessory, which is this trident or pitchfork or whatever you want to call this, which you can clip inside any of the palms, and it's fairly simplistic build from the leftovers, just to create something that would match the character of the devil quite nicely. You can as well take a closer look at the head sculpt, which looks basically like a robot with gigantic horns and face mask and green eyes. Here you can see the figure from the back, so I can show you how you can articulate the tail. So all the six hinge sections move independently, so you can create different poses. As well, try to cover as much of the rear of the mech as I could. You can find as well the jet thruster over here between the wings, which can be actually rotated a little bit back and forth, and you can as well articulate any of the wing sections as you please, because they are on hinges. You can as well see that the whole torso is actually just clipped on, so you can rotate it independently in the hips, so this way it as well makes the building a lot easier, because you can build the lower and top section separately and afterwards just click them together. There is no articulation on the neck. Basically it's attached on a single stud, so you can rotate it and you can as well simply knock it off if you want, but I couldn't find a better looking solution. You can as well angle the horns back and forth, and you can angle them more sideways if you want to. Here on the shoulders you can find two stud shooters that allow the mech to defend itself against the enemies, and if you open the chest you can find D.Va comfortably standing inside the chest compartment, so it allows her for very comfortable control of the whole mech. The shoulders are ball-jointed, the same goes for the elbows, and you have as well ball-jointed wrists with articulated fingers and thumb, so you can place them however you really want. Here on the back of the shoulder pad you can place D.Va's blaster, and that's pretty much about it. So let's move to the leg section. So the hip joints move in and out and can rotate back and forth. You can rotate the knees 360 degrees if you really want to, even though it wouldn't be very realistic, and you can bend the knees up to here when the parts of armor collide, and then you can bend them 90 degrees to the back. And here are the problematic high heels, which are on the click hinge, so they can move into all these positions. You can as well articulate the toes of the mech, and you can as well articulate the ball jointed high heels, which kind of helps to pose it and find the right balance properly. Did you like what you saw? Well, then maybe you should leave a comment and hit the like button. And if you are new to my channel, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. That way you cannot miss out on any of my future content, because I'm usually uploading weekly videos with my alternate builds or the free video instructions for some of my models. And if you would like to see the video instructions for this particular model, I'm gonna wait until it reaches at least 1000 views and gets minimum 100 likes. So it's in your hands again. Share the video if you want to see the instructions happening. And until next time, take care and bye bye. This was the She-Devil and Reinhardt's Eagle Flyer, which is my second alternate model of the LEGO Overwatch 75973 set.